Hi, my name is Zoran Horvat. In this video, I will talk to you about virtual functions, what it means to declare a virtual function, to invoke it, and what happens when you override a virtual function. If you like what you learn from this video, please subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to tick the bell if you want to receive notifications when new videos appear. Also, this discussion has been covered in much greater depth in my video course, Beginning Object-Oriented Programming with C#, published at Udemy. If you want to watch that course, please use the link from the description, because that will give you a huge discount. In that course, I'm discussing construction of classes, including virtual functions, overriding, the role of runtime, resolution of virtual functions, and everything else that comes packed with object-oriented programming. And now let's step to code, where I will show you what it means to declare and invoke virtual functions in plain C#. We could declare a base class and derive a class from it. Nothing special happens yet. Things will change when we declare a virtual function which, say, returns just a string, which depends on the concrete type of this object. If we step into the derived class, that same method, whoami, will exist there as well. We don't have to implement it there, we don't have to write anything. This method will be inherited from the base class. There is still no overriding here, but as you may know, the getType method will return a different result based on a concrete type of the object. Let me demonstrate how that works. I will introduce a function, report, which just prints the result of calling this virtual function. And I will invoke this report method two times, once with the base instance and another time with the derived instance. But please observe, the report method doesn't know the concrete type of its argument. It is receiving the base reference. So all it can do is to call methods defined on the base class and inherited by the derived class. It's not possible to call some method only derived class has. That is the object substitution principle. So when invoking the report method, we can pass either the base or the derived object of the derived class, but the report method can only operate on members of the base class. We can run this application and it will really display two distinct strings coming from the getType method or from the name property of the object returned by the getType method. So at this point, we have one virtual method, but we didn't change it, we didn't override it. GetType, by the way, is not virtual. It doesn't have to, because its working principle is a bit different. It works with the reflection. But now look, what if I added another virtual function, which also returns a string, but then chose to override it in the derived class? Now we have two distinct bodies for the same function. Base class has one body and the derived class has a different body defined. So if I went above to the report and invoked this method again on the base reference, what would happen? All right, let's run the method and see. In both cases, the appropriate function body would execute. But how does C# know this? That is how virtual functions work. A virtual function is attached to an object. It is declared at a base type and possibly overridden in the derived type. Of course, the derived type doesn't have to override the virtual method if it is satisfied with what the base type does, like this whoami method we made first. It doesn't have to override it, but if the derived type has an objection, knows it better, then it can override the function and provide a different implementation. Now, the choice of implementation at the runtime is made on the object, not on the declared type of the reference to that object. So the report method is indeed referencing a base type, but that is only what it knows about. It will invoke members of the base, but then which method body or implementation will effectively execute depends on the object, not on the declared type. In the first call, when the actual object is object of type base, the call to what do I do method will resolve to the definition from the base class. And in the second call, when actual object is an object of the derived type, the second implementation, that from the derived class, will be resolved and invoked. That is how virtual functions effectively work at runtime. Always remember, the virtual function is resolved from the object, not from the reference class or type. This is the 101 of virtual functions. Now the trick question. Do you know how does C# implement that mechanism? How does that work, really work? Well, one answer is in the course Beginning Object-Oriented Programming with C#. You can watch that course. Again, use the link from the description to get the discount. And I will give you a quick glance at the mechanism of resolving virtual functions in C# in the next video. So please watch for notifications when the new video appears. In that video, I will implement the resolution of virtual functions. When the video appears, the link will also appear in the description of this video. I hope you enjoyed this short demonstration of virtual functions, and see you in the next video, which will be much more complicated than this one.